that has got what my dream is designed on. This is the man who has never been corrupt and is not corrupt. This is the man who was born in the feet of the camel house. This is the man whose drainage, whose aspiration, whose accommodation, whose food, whose bed was actually urinated on by camels, sheep, and goats. And he overwent all that to be what he is today, to become the best teacher in Alliance Boys, that's Alliance High School, the Nana School, Upper Hill, and Stare. I looked into all those and I said, if a man can teach in these schools and can bring out all the important brains we have, including Peter Kenneth, who am I not to work under him even if I'm a professor? I'm echoing this to those who are saying that you are a professor of law with more than 7 law degrees. You cannot work under a teacher. Let me remind them that even Moi was a primary school teacher. Moi was a primary school teacher. Mheshimiwa Dida was a secondary school teacher. And under Moi, we had Saitoti. Saitoti was a professor of what? Mathematics. Kibaki was an economist, vice president. Kalonzo Musyoka, a lawyer, vice president. Muli Awori, vice president. Raila Odinga, prime minister under who? Kibaki. Now, who am I or who are they to judge? Why should you judge my book if you have not read it and I've read it myself? I've read this man you see here. He might look very small. He might have a red beard. He might have short trousers, but his brain is a brain of a giant. And I'm asking the American government, I'm asking Donald Trump, I'm asking the Prime Minister of the United Kingdom, I'm asking the President of France, I'm asking the President of South Africa, and I'm asking my brother, Yoweri Museveni, that do not look at Uhuru Muigai Kenyatta alone. Do not look at Raila Odinga alone. Because these two families have been there living and leading us forever. The war in this country is between two families. In this election, one family is going to beat down the other family. Yes. We need room in this country for people like me and Dida. Yes. A Chokora boy and a Hearts boy. Yes. A Chokora boy and a Hearts boy. To come in and show the way. Even Jesus Christ was born in a madhouse. A madhouse which had cows, which had animals that were ready to eat each other, urinating on each other. They urinated on him and he became the savior of the world. Just like Dida was born in a madhouse, his time has come. These are the people who know. Here is a man who knows where the rubber bites the shoe. We have looked at everything in this country. Everything needs fixing. People like us cannot be accepted in this government. People like us cannot even be called by NASA. Because they know that when we go there, we shall ask for the truth, and they don't like the truth. You look at NASA, you look at the graveyard scandal. You look at NASA, you look at Tokyo scandal. You look at NASA, you look at Molasses scandal. You look at NASA, what scandal don't we know that they are inbred in, and that's why they are looking for power, so that they can maintain themselves. They can commingle themselves with corruption. They can continue the epic of that corruption so that they cannot be prosecuted. Mheshimiwa Dida, you take over, Shimolatewa prison will be ready. Shimolatewa prison will be ready. Kuna ingine Kakamega sijui inaitwa namna gani. Sukuza is ready. Ile ya Machakos pia iko tayari. Industrial area prison is tayari. Wale ambao wameiba pesa za wananchi. Wale ambao wameiba madawa kwa hospitali. Wale ambao wameiba pesa za walimu. Wale ambao wameiba pesa za NYS. Na wengine sasa tunataka kusimama at governor. You elect a thief who has a scandal. Unampatia tikiti ya Jubilee. Awe governor ibe zaidi. Tunza. First task, first week in power. We shall round them up and show them the prison. And we shall ask the lawyers who are with us here today, the majority of us being lawyers on this platform, to do their work, defend them knowing that the prison doors are open. We shall have a new Inspector General of Police to put these people in prison. That is where they belong. That is where they belong. But however, being Kenyans, we are so good in forgetting where we are coming from. We need to fix the economy of this country. There's too much insecurity. What is our national security policy? The president doesn't have somebody to advise him on national security. We have not had anyone issuing a press statement who is qualified to speak on national security issues. All we know is that the government lets Americans to come in this country and pick up Kenyans, put them in the plane, and go and fix them in their prisons, as if we don't have the constitution, we don't have the sovereignty, we don't have the guidelines, we have not given up our sovereignty to the leadership, the executive, to abuse us because of the superpowers. Wengine wameiba mpaka mewashinda kumeza. Wameiba. The likes of Jubilee government. The president, I'm telling you, we are here. And we don't fear you. Because we gave you the mandate to rule this country. You have abused this mandate. And Tunza will tell you from today onwards, we are not afraid of you. If you are a good president, put these people in prison. If you don't go to prison yourself, then put them in prison. Let them account for the money they have stolen in this country. Let them not go out and tell us, ah, wengine wako na nini, atawana president. Deputy President Mr. Ruto, it's your time. It's your time now to know that we are here. Account for all the sins that are being committed in Jubilee government. Right or wrong?
Right.
Can we speak again?
Right.
Why can't they come out and tell us where they have taken this money? Five billion medical money earmarked for healthcare. People are dying, and the government is renegating on the collective agreement they made with the doctors in 2013, which was awaiting implementation. Wamefanya doctors have suffered, Kenyans are dying, patients are dying, there's no water, there's no nothing. All doctors, if you're hearing me, this is the place you call home. This is the ground you should come in and join us. We know what you are going through because we come from down there. We are the voice of the voiceless. We are the voice of the majority. You look at electricity, power. We need to open competitive bidding for power so that we have other private companies to come in and sell power. The world has moved very highly. The world has moved very far. If you go to the United States of America, you go to Britain, you'll find so many affordable companies or companies with affordable power structures whereby we cannot rely on a monopoly. In our government, Mheshimiwa, with my permission, we shall disband the Kenya Power and Lightning. We shall create privatization to sell us electricity. We shall disband any other body that has been created in this country for purposes of looting money by putting commissioners in those bodies who are not fit to be in government. The government and the country today, the country is burning today. We are all burning. We are burning why? Because of some leaders who only care about their